We are. We are. I see you. Wait.
And we are live on the Facebook. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Inner City Longform Improv Jam for this evening, if you're in the US, of September 27th, 2020. I'm Michael. I'll be emceeing today. Let's get started. I just need to share my screen here. All right. Can somebody confirm they can see that?
Yes.
Beautiful. Thank you.
Yes.
So as stated, this is the Inner City Longform Improv Jam. First, I'll talk about the format, how this is actually going to work tonight. This is not the actual roster, but when you came in, you chose musical or non-musical improv. You'll be randomly assigned to one of upwards of four teams, two musical, two non-musical. We'll have hosts later who will actually introduce each team. So when you hear your name, you know you're up. Each set is a 15-minute montage. If we see a really good moment at like 14 and a half, we might call it a little early. Don't worry about it. Mechanics are you can do sweep edits, you can do tag outs, you can do walk-ons, you can do walk-offs. Everybody go ahead and I'll stop to share for a moment. Everybody go ahead and turn on your video. And the way a sweep edit it will work is when you see a good moment to end a scene, you're going to turn on your video. You're going to wave your hands across the camera and say sweep a few times to make sure that everybody gets it. So, yeah.
Sweep.
Why? I'm waving my
hand. An emphasis on turning on your video and repeating it, because sometimes somebody else is talking and they miss it. You said sweep and they just think you entered the scene. And the band is having a great time. That is awesome. Alrighty. And yeah, for a tag out, again, pop on your video. Maybe hold up your hand just to make the mechanic clear and say tag out so-and-so or tag out everybody but so-and-so and things like that. Thank you, Laura. At about 2 minutes left or when the timer for your set thinks that the scene, not thinks, decides that the scene currently going is your final scene, they'll pop on the video and shake their phone. That means you're in the last scene or about to be in the last scene. And if you want to have a big finale, maybe now's your chance to jump on in. If we hear background noise and you're not in the current set, you may get muted, which means one of us has to unmute you later when you do want to talk or turn on your video. So if you do have background noise and you're not playing, go ahead and just mute your audio anyway. Oh, exactly what I just said. Also, I recommend that you hide non-video participants. That's in video settings. There's a checkbox, hide non-video participants. Or if you're currently actually seeing a grid, if you see this grid and you just see a gray box with somebody's name, you can right click on that and choose hide non-video participants. And that way you just get the lovely faces of people that are currently sharing their video. Some advanced audio settings. If you go into settings audio, you want to disable automatically adjust microphone input volume. And then if you go into advanced there, do check show in meeting option to enable original sound. And set those other three settings to disable audio. That, especially if you're doing musical improv, but in general, those will give you optimal audio settings and a better chance for people to hear you and for you to hear them. Oh, and if you can see on the bottom, after you exit out of audio settings, click where it says turn off original sound. So it shows, or click turn on original sound. So it shows turn off original sound. So that means original sound is on and your transmitting audio is better quality. We are streaming on Facebook, as I mentioned right at the top. You can actually click on the top of Zoom and get the link directly, and then you can paste it to all your community or Facebook pages so everybody else can watch your show. So a few tips for improv on Zoom. One person speaking at a time, Zoom doesn't do well with more than two, and suddenly somebody just gets cut out. Treat others with respect, be polite. You know, we're all here to have a good time. Feel free to laugh and share things you like in the group chat, but don't troll. Like, don't make fun. Don't call out what you might not consider good improv. Just like, oh, that was a funny line, or this is great. Be assertive, be aggressive, move it along. In other words, you only have 15 minutes. If you have an impulse, follow the impulse. Like, don't cut somebody off, but like, don't politely wait. Please use your actual face. If you have a stuffed animal, you can use it, but make sure we can actually see you, because your stuffed animal, I guarantee, is not as expressive and beautiful as you are. Yeah, look out for your teammates. If you've been on stage a lot, maybe take a step back. Or if you start a scene and somebody else hasn't been on for a while, actually specifically call them in, like, you know, sweep, bring in so-and-so. When you're doing music, focus on phrases more than the beat. This helps compensate for the lag because it is a little different for each of us as well. When the time, as I mentioned, when you see the timer warning, you know, that's your last chance for your set. So if you have an idea or just decide it's a group scene, that's fine. And yeah, do have fun, laugh, helps lighten up the mood. So there's a few sensitive topics. These are not outright banned, but tread carefully. Anything political or COVID related, we get plenty of that every day. It's okay. We deserve a little break from it. Religion, spirituality, you know, those are important to people, so be careful. Blue humor, that just means anything adult. Like, keep it more PG, maybe a little PG-13. Don't make fun of socioeconomic disadvantage. Avoid cursing, C-word, other words, a lot of four-letter words, some are more than four letters. And these are just examples of sensitive topics. This isn't everything. And then there's topics, please don't touch on these at all. Don't flash parts of your body. Don't make light of rape, kidnapping, miscarriage, suicide. Avoid racism, sexism, other isms. Avoid making fun of mental illness. Basically, don't make fun of anything that's somebody's personal identity, their appearance, their look, their beliefs, their thoughts, anything that is integral to their selves. And again, these are just examples, not an exhaustive list. Do stick around to the end. After the four jam sets and the headliner, we will have a group game. We'll discuss the team that's headlining next week. And then you'll also get a chance to share, you know, creative projects you're on, jams you're running, shows you have, just a funny YouTube video some friends made. We'd love to hear about those. And, oh, Fest, you know the slides happen to be updated?
What? I'm super busy sharing the live stream, so you're going to have to click around.
Okay, so I possibly... Oh, there we go. So the headliner this week is Bantam Roosters. I'll update the slides later to have their name on it. It's a musical team formed from the Inner City Improv Jam community. So a lot of familiar faces, you know. They decided to get together and do a musical set for you after all the jam sets.
We also have a band.
Oh, yeah, and they'll be accompanied, and the musical sets today will be accompanied by the band. That's a three-piece band. We've got keyboard, we've got drums, we've got violin. It's awesome. And we are, am I getting ahead? Nope. And we are always looking for headlining teams, sketches to play between the sets, or even if you play an instrument and want to accompany, you know, let us know. Go to the Inner City Longform Improv Jam webpage and send it a message and say, hey, I can provide one of these things. And that is me talking for plenty enough time. So let's go ahead and get rolling for set number one. Let's introduce your host, Bianca.
Thank you, Michael. Good evening, everyone. Your team number one, the first non-musical set of the night is, as I say your name, please turn your cameras on. Give it up for Kevin from New York City, Michael Ostrowskas from San Bruno, California, Nelson Morgan from Oklahoma, Jess Kent from Omaha, Nebraska, Cassie from Tucson, Arizona, Greg Little from Berkeley, California, and Josh Jenkins from Las Vegas, Nevada. For your timekeeper tonight, we'll have Brian Sebi timing you. We've got 15 minutes. Have fun.
Can we get a word?
Yes.
Thunderstorm.
Word.
Thunderstorm, thank you.
Did you hear that?
I do.
Oh.
I hate that sound. It's all tinny and scary. It
rattles the windows. Why did Mom and Dad have to go out tonight?
They left us all alone. They said buy pizza and then just left us here.
Well, I wish I had pizza.
Well, I mean, we can buy pizza, but then we gotta make somebody go out in that and bring us pizza.
What if the power goes out?
Well, if the power goes out, I mean, we can eat pizza by candlelight.
Okay, you really want pizza. Well, I guess I do,
too. We both want pizza.
Okay, maybe we should order it before we lose power and we can't make a call.
Yeah.
Hey, I heard you guys want pizza. I'm the pizza fairy.
Pizza fairy?
Mm-hmm. Pizza fairy?
Yeah.
I didn't even say the words I wish.
Yeah.
Well, okay.
Tell me what you want.
I like cheese and sausage and pepperoni, mushroom.
Oh, you always want pepperoni.
Pepper, black olive, pineapple, but not sardines.
And I don't want pepperoni, but I do want sardines.
Tag out Jess and Michael. This pizza fairy idea of yours is a fantastic idea. I just watched you kill it, eat both of those children.
Yeah. Oh, man. They never suspected. No. In fact, while they were arguing, that's when I got them. Yeah.
Yes. Yes. I should try to become one of these, food fat, fatties, so I can pop in on kids who want to eat. And it's like, oh, can I have some ice cream? Yes, here it is. And now I'll eat you.
I think I might have walked in on a crime, but here's your guys' pizza.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, she'll take the pizza, and I'll eat your face!
Oh, the pizza's fantastic.
Sorry, I'm full.
This is great dessert. Hey, I just want to tell you that on Tuesday, I'm gonna be in late. I have a dental appointment.
That's fine. Yeah, mostly, we've just been holding, meetings and stuff here. A lot of brainstorming sessions, figuring out how we're going to, eat more kids.
Yeah. Yeah. Last week I was thinking about every time kids bring up M&Ms, and there's going to be an M&M fairy too. It's incredible.
Ooh.
Oh, there he is right now.
Did somebody call me the M&M fairy? Is it this? This is M&M's with peanut butter. They are so delicious.
Mm.
Oh, look. There it is in the cup.
Yeah.
You cannot beat peanut butter M&M's.
Wait, hold on. Are you two about to try to eat us? Because, we're all co-workers, right?
Yeah.
Man, it really sucks, working the top of the water slide in the middle of a storm like this. Like, you just have to get rained on the whole time.
And then the lightning. I mean, we're on the top of a water slide. It's like begging.
Yeah.
Begging to be hit.
Can I go?
Go ahead. Green light. Green light, kid. Go. Ah. I mean, it doesn't stop people from coming. I mean, because they get in and just go to the end of the line and come right back. But, all right. Hold on. Even though that kid's the second one, the red light's still up. So go ahead and get positioned.
There's a red light.
All right, it's green. It's green. Go
ahead. Only one of you.
Oh, my God. They both went. Oh.
Hold on. Am I next?
You're next. We have a collision.
Look down there at the end of the slide. Those bodies are entangled.
Pack out everyone. Bring in Greg. Whoa! Make way, kid! Whoa!
You're stuck!
Oh no!
You're stuck!
Oh no! Hi.
Hi.
I'm Toby.
I'm also Toby.
Oh.
What's funny to me is that we're both named Toby and we're in a tube.
Toby's in a tube. Okay.
Yeah, I like to make it's because it's a pretty scary situation, but it's good to find the humor in it.
Yeah.
I hope they don't send down another kid. I think that I'm not sure it'll help.
I'm convinced it would unjam us and not make the situation worse.
How?
Look out! Here I
hear. I hear something going.
Oh!
Tag out all three of you. Bring back the people who were at the top of the slide. Okay. I know the first 36 kids you sent down are now all stuck down there together.
Yeah.
But I'm convinced that when we send this 36th one, that will, yeah, that one will unblock the whole
side. I can just go ahead and go? Thank you.
Go ahead, green light. Whee!
I mean, we live and die by that light.
Okay, maybe the 38th time will be the charm.
As long as the light goes green.
I think you need somebody my size that's willing to go head first, and I can unjam it. I promise you, I can unjam this slide.
I like your style.
Okay, I like it. I'm going. Here we go. Are you ready?
Green.
Are you ready?
Yeah, let's try it.
Here we go.
Get it on. Ah,
ah, everybody inside the tube.
This hurts.
I can't see.
You're dislodged. Get on down the slide. Go. Success.
Hooray. Man, I'm so glad.
And sweet.
That slide.
All right, Thor. We need to talk.
Yes.
Well, first, you should probably stop throwing the hammer around.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, that's what I do. Yeah. I throw the hammer first, and then it just bounces all around.
Right, and you've been creating a lot of thunderstorms, you know, down on Earth, which we're all happy with your job performance.
Oh, thank you.
We are. Overall,
I wanted to bring up that these pants are really tight, and I don't feel right in these pants that you've got me wearing this week.
Oh, somebody told you you needed to wear those pants.
Yes, yes.
Do you remember who that was? Because, yeah, that's...
Well, it was by brother, email, of course.
Brother, don't tell him about the pants. I sent that only to you.
Loki.
Yes.
Loki, how many times have we here in HR had to call you in, you know, to discuss these kinds of things?
I feel like I'm not doing it right if it's not under 100 times a week.
Well, the good news is it's only Tuesday and you're already up to 74.
Yes.
Ah. I just wanted to say I was really uncomfortable. That was just my feedback. I just wanted to make sure you guys knew the feedback that I was given about my pants.
That's you can wear your own pants to work, you know, as long as, you know, they're appropriate.
Oh.
You win this round.
Yeah, Thor, I'm going to be busy with your brother for a bit. Let me just say, we just wanted you to spread the love around. You've been dumping on like one part of the world for like the last 7 days. So, you know, mix it up a bit.
I'm going to work on the Southern Hemisphere for a while. And I'm going to go feed the cat too. He's meowing over here.
Okay. All right. Now, Loki.
Son, am I right?
Loki?
Yes.
Now, this morning, I had to speak to you because you accidentally fed, you know, Sleipnir to Fenris.
I did.
And we had to, you know, I mean, it took a lot of work to get, you know, those two extricated.
And the three whoopee cushions that I left on your chair all throughout the day.
Oh, that's what that was. Okay. Yep. Definitely went on the list.
Yes.
All
right. It's up to 78 now. I gotta work a little harder for the rest of the week.
Yes. Well, I'm putting the three.
Hey.
Hey.
Are you getting all those things done that I've coached you with about the whoopee cushions and everything else? What's your latest prank that you're gonna do?
Oh, well, you see, I've decided to turn my brother Thor into a frog.
Oh, a hippity hop frog?
A hippity hop frog, yes.
Oh,
isn't that very mischievous of me?
Oh, it's so mischievous of you. Oh, with frog legs and all. Oh. Is it going to be a toad frog?
I've decided as long as he has warts, it'll be good. It could be any kind of a frog.
Oh, but, a warty frog.
Tell me, Father Odin, what kind of pranks are you going to play on Thor this week?
Oh, you know what I'm going to do? I am going to make
him... Cut to those pranks! Oh.
Where is Thor? Where is Thor? Thor?
Oh, well. Oh,
Thor. Thor.
My exercise. Yeah.
You need to go check your closet.
Oh, well, sure. Of course.
Go ahead. Go check your closet.
Oh, okay.
Dump.
It's a gremlin.
And tell me, how did that make you feel?
It scared the hell out of me.
Well, then I succeeded. Look, instead of reseating, I succeeded.
Yes.
I scared you.
You know, you're pretty funny. I think you're one of my funniest friends, other than my brother. Yeah.
Oh well, I'm so glad that I could be so funny, honey.
Hey, I'm gonna bop you over the head. Boom.
Oh. Didn't work, did it?
I didn't put anything behind it. It was my.
Oh, go ahead. Go ahead. Give me your best. Oh!
Sweep. So, new song, Thunderstruck. What do you think? I can't hear you.
Sorry, I didn't turn on the booth microphone. I love it. I love electric guitars. I love drums. I love bass. What else do you need?
Like everything you've got. Like I need percussion. I need lights. I need explosions.
Let's make it happen. Let's bring back the wall of sound. 40-piece band.
Absolutely. Now, we need a venue for this that's going to be fabulous.
Madison Square Garden. Taj Mahal.
Madison Square Taj Mahal. What?
No, two different things.
Oh.
I like the way that Madison Square Garden, the Taj Mahal. You know what? Have you ever played in the International Space Station?
I have not.
Well, let's make that happen.
I have a feeling explosions might not work so well.
Don't limit yourself. If you're used to explosions, we can make explosions happen. And who cares if we're in a pressurized container literally thousands of miles above the Earth?
I mean, if you're going to go down swinging, right?
Yeah.
Okay, tag out Michael and Jess. Bring in somebody who hasn't been in. Today, the band AC/DC blew up the International Space Station, resulting in the deaths of not only the band, but a 40-piece orchestra, as well as three heroic astronauts. The debris from the space station has fallen to Earth, and it crushed Madison Square Garden in the middle of a hockey game, resulting in hundreds more deaths. Here to talk about this.
Honey, what are you watching? What are you watching on there?
I just the evening news, dear. I really should change it. I know.
It sounds terrible.
Doesn't it? I mean, really, like every day.
Can you just turn it to a cartoon station while I'm working back here?
Yeah, sure. I'll change the channel.
Turn it to a cartoon for me. Thank you, honey.
Oh, man. It's that kid stuck in the slideshow. I love that one.
We interrupt the kid stuck in the slideshow.
Yay.
Everybody go ahead and turn on your camera and give a clap for Team One. For some quiet jazz hands. Awesome. So you may have noticed, I love M&Ms. I also love branded merchandise. Check this out. I have an Inner City Long Form Improv Jam branded mug. Oh, and look at Faustino. Not only is he jumping, he has an Inner City t-shirt. And I bet there's a bunch of you who also have merchandise. Oh, look at that. Brian with a sticker. Janelle with a nice dark shirt. Oh, we got Jess. Is that a magnet?
I made it into a magnet from a sticker.
Jess turned a sticker into a magnet. Bianca has a mug. Don has a sticker. David has a cat and a shirt. And, Faustino, can I steal sound? Do you mind if I share? I don't want to screw up your sound setup.
Do it.
Okay, cool. One moment. So there is an Etsy page where you can help yourself to all this merch. And I'd like to point out, this mug, not only 11 ounces, 15 ounces. This is 15 ounces of M&M's, all. But T-shirts in several cuts. Two different designs of mug. We got a sports shirt. We got a hoodie. Colors, a pillow. I think I'm going to get one of those pillows myself, because that's adorable. And besides that, I'll share the link to both these in a moment. You can celebrate Inner City Long Term Jam by signing up to get a mask, and you can get a mask for free. This is a COVID-safe mask sporting the logo, fashionably on the edge, you know, rather than like right in front of your face. And it's absolutely free. I'll share the link, and you can get one as a way to commemorate and add another mask to your rotation, because why not have more? Don't do what I do and always end up looking for one and end up wearing a wet one. So Faustina, I'll return control to you for the audio. Otherwise, I'll do this slightly slowly to make sure Faustina can get that set up. We're about to roll into our first musical team of the day, hosted by Jess, whom you just saw playing.
Great. Hi, everybody. We have team two coming up. When I say your name, please come on screen. We've got Laura Z from San Francisco. We've got Bianca Garcia from Atlanta. We have David Shapiro from Chicago. We have Stephanie Ray from Miami, Florida. And we have Nick Condon from Portland, Oregon. And please get a suggestion. And our timer today is Michael Workowski. Thank you, Michael. All right. And I'm signing off.
Hey, many people know I should probably be in Temple tonight. For Yom Kippur, but I'm not. What is another thing that you should be doing that you're not doing?
Working out.
Working out. Thank you, working out.
Thank you, working out. So, bro.
Yeah, bro?
I've been coming here for like 2 days a week. For like 5 to 7 weeks now.
Yeah. You've been real intense about it, man.
Yeah. I noticed you noticing me is all I'm saying.
Yeah, man, I've been noticing you. And like, I think you've been noticing me too. Like, you've been looking at me and my protein shakes.
Yeah. And your protein shakes brings the boys to the yard is what I'm saying. Don't be embarrassed, bro. Don't be embarrassed.
I just, you know me, I buy the good stuff. I buy that like premium whey, the kind you got to buy online.
Yeah. Whey, bro. That's hardcore. You know what? Like, I noticed. You do so many things that other people don't do. Like, you wipe down every machine after you're done using it.
Oh, yeah, bro. Sanitation is, like, number one. I mean, number one compared to to your health, but...
She's clean, she's clean, she's clean. She's clean, you know, she's clean, she's clean, she's clean.
I would so use... machine after you, even if you didn't wipe it down.
Clean, clean, clean.
Look, clean, bro. Clean. There's something that I gotta tell you. I already started to allude to it earlier. I think that you and I should maybe see each other outside The gym? What do you say?
I would spot you.
You'd spot bro. Me, bro?
I would spot you.
Hell yeah, spot me, bro.
Yeah.
I don't think he understands what you mean. No, he doesn't.
Yeah, dude, like, spot me in life, right? Yeah? Spot me when we go to the park together. Spot me at the movies, yeah? Like, spot me at the fancy restaurant.
Bro, I'll spot you. I'll spot you. Wherever.
I think you get the idea.
That's all I ask for. Here's a protein shake.
Sweep, 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 sweep. I'm just like really broken up because Trevor told me he's been spotting someone else and like that was our thing. You know, I would do squats and he was like behind me making sure I didn't fall. And now I just feel like I could topple over at any moment. You know, Jenny?
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Jenny, I can't hear you.
I'm sorry. I'm just lifting these weights. Let me put it down. And you know, Jenny, you don't deserve that, Melissa. You have been by his side for the past 5 years, and you do not deserve to be dissed like this.
I know, like, he wasn't just my trainer. Like, I thought we were building something special, you know?
It was obvious. It was obvious. The two of you were like one. You moved together.
Right? You could see it, right?
I could see it.
We had, like, a special chemistry, like, I don't know. I felt like he was my dumbbell soulmate.
All right. I have a plan. If you want me to, I could do a little something to this other woman, if you'd like, to make sure she doesn't show up at the gym anymore.
You mean like steal her access card?
I was thinking more like give her extra calories in her candy health bars so that she'll be too ashamed to come back.
Oh, you mean like a workout sabotage?
Exactly.
Intrigue at the gym.
I like the way you think.
Workout sabotage. There are so many things that I can do. Break her spirit and make her go away. Just tell me. I can do anything you want in any way.
Oh, I appreciate you. You're such a good friend. We've been here since the beginning, and we'll be here till the end. I know she'll think that she's eating clean. I'm gonna sneak sugar into her protein. Workout sabotage.
Sabotage. Workout. Sabotage.
Sweep.
So, is there a trainer somewhere around here I could talk to? Looking for a personal trainer? Somebody maybe who knows how to use the machines? Maybe the help.
Oh, you need a trainer?
Oh, hey, yeah. Oh, bro. Oh, hey, yeah. How are you?
You don't need
how
to call me bro. It's cool. You don't seem like a bro kind of bro. It's okay.
No, I'm not. No, really, I'm not. I don't come here a lot, but my wife.
No, I totally couldn't tell.
You couldn't tell, I know. But listen. I hear there's something I could pay a little bit extra for some spotting.
Like, I don't do that anymore.
come on, bro.
Don't even try, bro. Don't even try.
Okay. I mean, I'm looking for the best, and if that takes some pro level spotting, that's what I'm gonna do.
I got someone for you.
Sure. I think you're my guy. I mean, you are the opposite of sister. I can't think of another word. Friend, pal, I don't know. I mean, can't we be bros? We're different, but we can be bros.
It was a long time ago.
Be my bro. Be my bro. Take care of me. Set me up. Do me a solid. Be my bro.
I'm going to tell you something that somebody once told me. The only bro we have to bro is bro.
Oh.
Itself.
Simple, really, it is. Sing more, tell me more.
Well, that took me a long time to grasp.
Bro, that's deep, bro. I think I understand, bro. I can spot myself. Spot myself. I will go from lot to lot so I can have a spot. Tell me more.
All right. You gotta spot yourself, take care of yourself, because no one else cares.
Self-spot!
No one else cares. Gotta take care of you.
Bro, put her there. Put her there, bro. Friends for life. I don't even know your real name, but friends for life.
Sweet.
Man, what a great workout. Oh. Yeah, I just wanted to come introduce myself. I really like your blue top. And I don't know, I make these homemade protein shakes, and I thought you might be interested in trying one.
What? Homemade protein shakes?
Yeah.
Well, like, yeah, I want to try one.
It's a special strength training recipe, so.
Oh, man, this has superfoods and acai.
Oh, yeah, all of that.
I drink them all the time. They're great.
Mm-hmm.
Mmm. That gives quite the punch.
Yeah, you know, I just really feel like we've all got to support each other, you know?
Yeah, I know exactly what you mean. Actually, would you like to become part of this gym? I think we could be selling this on our shelves every single day.
Oh, I'm not sure that you should.
And your product is
that
so good, we could give you a year-long contract. No, a 5-year contract.
That's
protein shakes were called.
Melissa's protein shakes.
Melissa's protein shakes. Oh yeah, totally.
Oh
what
boy.
Do you say?
Well. I think I'm in over my head. I think I'm in over my head.
I gave you that protein shake for a special reason, but now
it's really good.
I think I'm in over my head.
What do you mean? Do you need some help? Cause I can provide you with financial help. Do you need some space? Cause we have a spare office in the back. Don't worry about a thing. These protein shakes are thing. Just join this gym and help make us better. What do you say?
I made it just for you. Now you want to merchandise instead? I think I'm in a little bit over my head. I wasn't gonna tell you, but you turned out to be nice. I sabotaged that protein shake. I filled it up with rice. There's so many carbs in rice.
What?
It's not good for you at all.
Rice cake.
Why would you do that? I mean, because it's a gym.
You were working out with Trevor, and I was jealous, and I didn't know what else to do. I mean, your biceps are so defined.
Yeah, I mean, people tell me that all the time, but, listen, it doesn't have to be like that. Me and Trevor are over.
You know, I don't need Trevor. Your biceps are even better than his. Maybe I should be training with you.
Hey, you can train with me. I'm accepting new clients all the time. And this shake is the bomb. Come train with me.
Okay.
Come join this gym. And then see, we'll be having the best time.
I need a shake.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna train with you instead.
Join this gym.
Rice shake.
Yeah. I'm gonna train with you instead.
And
rockin'.
Great job.
Thank you.
Give a hand for team two.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, that was delightful. I remember going to the gym. Okay, and now we've got a little sketch for you. Oh, thank you, the band. Yes, give that band a hand, of course.
Woo! Yes, the band.
Woo! Hi, now.
And they will be. And now we have a little sketch that Faustino will share because he has an internet connection that's a little better than mine. It's called. It comes to us from Mark Kendall. So, Faustino, whenever you're ready.
What?
Yes, guys, this is Mark Kendall's If Marta Came to Cobb County from the area of Atlanta, Georgia. So give it up for Mark Kendall Comedy for supplying us with this beautiful sketch. Stall, clap, and stall.
Yeah, clap, stall, clap.
Hooray. Yeah. No sound.
We have no sound from the computer right now. Can you help us, Faustino?
It's part of the sketch.
It's not.
All right, y'all have a seat.
Now, is that good now?
Yes.
No, it's not.
We heard the hey guys have a seat.
It was very low, yeah.
Where Michael Ostrowska's Vamps for a second.
This is a banana.
Who's that in the corner of your room?
And as a child, you might have learned to open them from this end, but that only works if they're at like a certain point of ripeness.
You don't even need to open that banana. You can just like
get it from the middle.
All right, y'all have a seat. Now, in a crazy turn of events, they have decided to build MARTA trains straight to Cobb County. So you know what this means. we are finally taking black crime to Cobb County. This is something we have always wanted to do, but it's only possible now that we have trains. Many a night I've sat up and I've been like, I wish I could rob Cobb County tonight, but all I have is my Escalade. So tonight, we're gonna go over the plan for our first robbery. We're all gonna meet tomorrow morning at Five Points MARTA station at 8 a.m. What is it, Ricky?
Well, can we stop the Five Guys before we...
Five Guys doesn't even open until 11 a.m., Ricky.
Oh, my bad. I don't have a watch on.
It's all right, man. Now, we're gonna start at Five Points MARTA station. Everyone is buying their own Breeze cars this time, goddammit. All right? Ricky, you're bringing the guns. Leon, you're bringing the knives. And then Ronnie, you're gonna bring the universal charger. Just make sure that, like, all of our electronic accessories stay charged. We appreciate what you do. We're gonna hop on the Gold Line northbound, headed towards Doraville Station. At around 8:20 a.m., just to throw them off the track, we're gonna switch over to the Red Line. And we're just gonna be switching back and forth, back and forth. Now, if everything goes according to plan, we should be at the new Cobb County MARTA station by 8:40 a.m. Now, after the train ride, we're gonna have to hop on the 10 bus. What is it this time, Ricky?
Well, if we can't go to Five Guys, what about McDonald's? They got deals right now.
Ricky, McDonald's, generally speaking, is a drive-thru. The purpose of this is that we're using public transportation. So I guess what you would have to do is instill a democracy within the MARTA bus and have everyone vote to go to the McDonald's drive-thru.
Oh, my bad. I get you.
The 10 bus is going to take us all the way to Fair Oaks. After our bus ride, it's just a short 6-mile walk to the house that we want to rob. That's easy. Now, once we're inside the house, we only have time to go after the good stuff, all right? I'm talking about Xbox controllers and pianos. But if we have extra time, we're gonna mess around in their house, all right? So we're gonna go into their refrigerator, take all that Chobani yogurt, right? We're gonna go upstairs, ride their Peloton bike. We're gonna log on to their Netflix account and watch the Netflix original movie, The Princess Switch, starring Vanessa Hudgens of High School Musical fame, in which Vanessa Hudgens of High School Musical fame plays two identical strangers, which is a stretch given her acting ability. I ain't trying to throw no shade at Vanessa Hudgens. I'm just stating the facts. Anyway, in this movie, Vanessa Hudgens plays two identical strangers, and both identical strangers have the same hand tattoo, yet is never addressed in the plot, and it really gets in your head. Anyway, back to robbing this piano. All right, we're gonna take all the stuff and we're gonna go 6 miles back to the bus stop. What is it, Ricky?
How about I order Five Guys on Grubhub?
What, we don't want to give away our location on a GPS. Now, we know this, people. We have got to make that bus stop at 11 a.m. sharp. Because if we miss that bus, we're gonna have to wait for the next 2 weeks until the next one shows up. And we all know Chobani yogurt cannot survive 2 weeks of direct sunlight. Now, once we get back to the new Cobb County MARTA station, that's when things get dangerous. You're gonna be a black man riding the MARTA train, holding a piano. So be prepared for someone to walk up to you and ask you, "Excuse me, sir, are you Stevie Wonder?" And the answer is always yes.
He's here.
You ordered Five Guys, Ricky?
Uh-huh.
Come on, man. I got you something too.
Wow.
Woo!
Woo! Comedy from Atlanta, Georgia! Go Bulldogs!
Hey!
Wow.
I'm so excited. Hey. Mark Kendall's awesome. He was an ensemble member at Dad's Garage.
Oh.
Get over Dad's Garage!
Yeah!
Dad's Garage!
Follow Mark Kendall on Instagram and Facebook at Mark Kendall Comedy.
Yeah, let's get those links in the chatter on our Facebook then.
Get over links! Woo!
Woo, links! You know, I was just thinking, if you don't know who the Ricky and your group of friends is, it's you. Let's move right along. Team 3, as hosted by Mr. Nick Condon.
All right. Let's give it up for Group 3. Who you'll be seeing featured in Group 3 is Alex Lee from La Cañada, California. Donna Paul from somewhere in Oregon. Ben Amiri from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Donovan from NYC. Rusty Bill from KC Mo. And Alex Taylor from Miami, Florida. Give it up for Team 3, y'all.
Oh, yeah.
Woo!
All right.
All right, can we get a suggestion? Any word?
Banana peel.
Can opener.
Water.
I heard banana peel and then can opener.
Water.
Let's take banana peel and can opener. I'm down.
Okay.
Thank you.
Whoa! Tell you not to leave the banana peels around.
I'm sorry, Jimmy. It's just that we don't have a receptacle specifically for banana peels, so I get confused every time, and I just throw them on the floor.
Well, you don't have to put an entire pile, Jimmy, of it. Ow.
Well, sometimes I like to push them down so that they don't slide quite as much, and then I fall down. So I know how you feel. I'm really sorry.
We have to be really careful. I mean, we work in a nursing home. I mean, think of all the residents slipping on them. I mean, it's a miracle that I've been the only person slipping on. Wait a minute. Have you been just leaving these banana peels just on me, just for me?
No. Why would I do that, Timmy? You're my friend.
I got Alex. Did you tell him about the secret banana stash for me, Caesar, the chimp? You better keep it a secret.
I keep it a secret, don't worry.
When we apes rise, you will be our number one human, Rusty, Jill, Hill, Bill.
Yeah. Why on earth do us chimpanzees always have fleas in our armpits? It really stinks.
You're a chimpanzee too?
Did I say chimpanzee? I meant orangutan.
Oh my God. You look so much like a human. You are a man on the inside. How? Oh my God. You're disgusting to look at. Sorry.
I keep this on.
That was mean. I didn't mean that, Rusty Pill. Look. Soon the humans will be destroyed, and it will be a new war. A war of the apes. Because we will...
That sounds like a cheesy 1960s movie to me.
Do not question our war, all right? We bring to the humans. The humans have beaten us down, put us in zoos, and put us in crappy films with Air Bud. I'm sick and tired of doing films with Air Bud.
But you know, way back when, that Ronald Reagan guy, he was good with chimps.
Ronald Reagan can kiss my ass, okay? And he's passed away 20 years ago today.
Oh.
You see...
Oh, how about that guy in the big rig that was driving around and he had a chimp with him? That was good.
Mark Ruffalo?
I don't know.
It was Mark Ruffalo from Princess Diaries.
Really?
Yeah. Listen, huh. That bastard. Excuse me. Oh, sorry. I'm not supposed to curse. I'm a chimp. I hate Mark Ruffalo.
All right, you chimps. It's enough talking. The human is here. And you guys are going down because you're not going to take over this planet. Humans will live forever.
Me monkey, me no speak English.
I can hear you. I've been listening to both of you the last hour. I know you can speak.
We're monkeys. We don't speak. You're a dumb human.
Okay. All right. Let's negotiate.
Look, Dr. Filibuster, I understand that you think it's just that we, you know what I'm saying?
No, I don't know what you're saying. All I understand that you two apes are the last apes.
Be stupid.
And I'm the last human.
What? When did this happen?
You missed it. It was over the last 20 years.
Damn it. We were supposed to take over, me and Bill. That's why he had his idiot nephew slip.
Yeah, I took care of all the rest of the apes.
Sweep and bring in a Ben. So you're saying, Ben, that your two roommates are having trouble with the recycling and that one of them is like, you suspect that he's wearing a mask of some sort?
Yeah, just little clues, you know, like I think he's hiding something. Like I saw his face in the sink one day. And that's like suspicious, you know? When I see someone's face separate from their body in the sink, a little alarm goes off in my head. Can't trust this guy.
Well, according to our sessions and a couple of weeks ago, you mentioned that you found an undisclosed amount of hair in the bathroom that just had the wrong color, was orange, and nobody there has orange hair.
Yeah. Is it cool if I eat this corn in your office? You don't mind, do you? Just like straight out of the can, that's cool with you?
All right. You know, I mean, I understand about the banana peels and the recycling and the whole 10 yards, but your roommates, that sounds like a tricky situation.
That's your advice? It's a tricky situation?
Well, no, I haven't given you the advice yet. I'm just saying.
Like you're here to solve my problems, right?
No, you have to solve them.
What am I here for?
Yeah, just, you know.
Oh, is this one of that bullshit things where, like, I'm here to, like, talk until I figure out what the solution is myself? Is that what this is? Oh, my God. What a ripoff. So I'm not going to get any solutions out of you. Are you telling me that right now?
I'm ready to tell you that I think it's a time for a confrontation. That's all.
What are these degrees on your wall for, huh?
Well, that's what they're there for, is to tell you that it is absolutely time for you to confront that. If that roommate is wearing a mask indeed, that is superfluous and not acceptable to your rental degree.
I got Donna. Ben, I was just taking something out of the dishwasher. You said you needed to confront me?
Yeah, that's right. I think there's a lot of distrust and deceit going on in this house.
Hey, dude, what's going on, dude? Oh, mm-hmm. Man. Oh.
That's right. Yeah, everyone come on in.
All the roommates?
Yeah, everyone, because I think we have some stuff we need to hash out. I just want to throw this out here. I'm going to say that there is someone or someones in this house who is not the species that they claim to be. And I'm looking in all your eyes.
Ridiculous.
Me monkey, me no understand.
I mean,
we're good roommates. None of us have cussed.
Right.
Yeah, which is suspicious. That just makes me think that one or more, I mean, Donovan claims he's a chimp, but I think that there's a good chance that underneath that, he's actually a human. And I think then the rest of you claim to be human might actually be chimps. And I just want to know where everyone stands. Is that so much to ask?
Ooh, I'm not a chimp.
My name, Donovan.
I'm not a chimp. And the last time I cussed, it was a sin, so that's why I can't cuss anymore. I got in trouble when I did that, so I don't cuss anymore.
Ah, the religious loophole. All right, that's fine. Well, I found this Alex-looking mask sitting in the sink. And Alex is right here. So either this is a spare mask that Alex uses on occasion, or Rusty Pill has been masquerading as Alex in his spare time.
We have to go to bar mitzvah.
How dare you, Rusty Bill?
Yeah, I gotta go too. They were called. Yeah, my girl's calling me. Yes.
My girl, right. But you see, he was just here. How could I be him if he was just here? I'm me.
And how convenient that those other guys have to leave. It is Yom Kippur, I suppose. Makes sense. But you two, something is going on here. Alex, does it bother you that Rusty Pill might be masquerading as you?
Rusty, get the rope. Let's tie him up.
Wait, why are you tying me up? Great. Now my green beans are on the floor. That's great.
Okay. You want a banana? That's fine.
We eat things off the floor.
I don't know if you're chimps or just gross humans.
Tag out Ben, bring back in the other monkeys. Order! Order, monkeys.
Okay.
Order, we...
Okay.
Cover.
Yeah. Yes, eight, Judge?
Please, call me Dr. Oregano.
Dr. Oregano. Oh, okay. You still go by your slave name?
Yes, it's my original name. Look, you've ruined the plan. You've tied up an innocent improviser, and you've ruined his life. You were supposed to tie up the Ben Amiri across the street.
He had green beans, though. You said look for the green beans. He had green beans.
There was one across the street.
Oh.
With a bushy,
wait, there's...
bushy beard on his face and a big bushy hair.
He has a twin brother?
No, it's just the same name on the same block. I told you to fact check it, and you monkeys messed it up. Look, I'm an orangutan, but I'm also half gorilla, so I understand.
I was going to say, being an orangutan, we're allowed one mistake a day. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
Yeah.
Being a gorilla, you're allowed too. But this is 3 mistakes in 1 week. First was the Air Bud incident. How long it took me to clean up that body? A month.
All dogs look the same.
Not this one when you guys were done. Sorry, that was dark. I didn't mean to go that dark. But look, what are we going to do? The other Ben Amiri, unfortunately, he's no longer with us. He went on a plane. He took a plane after you tied him up.
He flew a plane after we tied him up?
Humans are better talented than I thought.
Give me some white wine, please.
We cut to the airport. My ID's in my pocket if you could just grab it.
Yeah, well, I will.
Thanks. My boarding pass is on my phone. If you could just grab that out. Yeah, I don't have a paper copy.
Yeah, I can see. All right, turn around so I can put this in your back pocket. Thank you.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah, and I don't have...
No, your phone is a little dirty. It's not scanning, correct?
Yeah, just point it to my face. That should do it.
Oh, all right.
I always have to make the face.
Face ID. Unlocked? There we go. All right. Beep. All right, so you understand if you're going to get on this plane, you need... you need to be able to carry your carry-on, and apparently your arms are confined.
Well, yeah, I'm tied up. That's true.
So
I was hoping someone else could, help me with that.
Yeah. All right. I can call over the other stewardess, and she can take care of that. Yeah.
Well, thank you.
So Agnes, can you help this... passenger at the gate?
Sure, I'll be right there. Okay, I'm cutting.
Bring a knife. Ooh. Bring a knife.
Well, hello.
Hey, how you doing?
Hey, well, just fine. As you see, I have a carry-on here that I need to get on that plane, and my arm's sort of tied up at the moment. But
carry me on, sweetheart. All right.
nothing would make me happier, believe me.
Mr. HG does all the heavy lifting here at this gate, so...
I believe it.
I'll lift you, all right. Thank you, Donna. Donna, just tell the job I'll be on vacation for a week, okay?
We now pronounce you man and wife. You may kiss each other when you seem fit.
Yeah, absolutely. Mm. I mean... oh my gosh.
Sweet. They told me if I had an infinite number of me, thanks for helping out. We're writing a Shakespeare because if there's an infinite number of us, then we just hit random things on this machine and it's supposed to print out Shakespeare.
Now, boys, I've seen that play, so don't be plagiarizing. It's a one-act.
You want us?
He's in there typing. I know that.
You want us to do something original?
Yes, you need to do something original.
Oh.
Or the plagiarizing police will get you.
Excuse me.
In 10 seconds.
I'm sorry. Excuse me. I just wanted to leave this copy of a book I'm working on, but I'm not going to produce it. But Maybe you were waiting for somebody, Goodell.
Just left the book? I thought we were supposed to type things randomly. Like... doesn't smell edible.
My whole life is now meaningless. I was born to type Shakespeare randomly.
I'm still trying to get... See...
Have you seen that play where they do that? Where the two monkeys are typing?
Give it up for Team 4!
It's a...
That was Team 3!
It's a one act.
Oops! Yeah, everybody give a hand for Team 3!
Woo!
Alrighty. As mentioned before, there's a lot of community. I'll share some web pages and I'll put the links in the chat down below. Oh, and I have no lighting on my face because I'm viewing a dark web page. There we go, I cheated. So there are two web pages. There's the Inner City Longform Improv Jam web page. That's where you find out about events. That's where you can watch the live stream if you or one of your friends haven't already found it and shared it. But also, if you happen to be a musical director or no one, happen to be on a team that you'd like to headline or no one, or have a sketch you'd like us to show at some point, message that page. And then there's also the Inner City Longform Improv Jam Hub, which is a page where we just chat and share things. And let's move right into Team The Fourth, which will be hosted by Mr. Ben Ameri.
Thank you. So as I call your name, that means you're on Team 4, so come on. We've got Scarlett Rivera from Brooklyn, Danelle Marr from Fremont, California, Antoinette from St. Louis, Jim Reedy from Concord, and Michael Werkowski from San Diego. Your timekeeper will be Alex. So Alex will pop up when it is time for your last song. And with that, I give you Team 4.
Hey, we're Team 4. Can we get a suggestion of anything?
Marbles.
Corn chips.
Marbles.
I heard marbles. Let's go with marbles.
Great. It's not fun to play a game of marbles by yourself.
Oh! I was looking all over for you, Tamara. Oh. I've got our marbles.
Oh, thanks. Oh my! I was wondering what happened to you.
I tripped on a marble and then I saw the light.
You saw the light?
Yeah, and it made me think that I was mean to you, and I should play marbles with you instead of letting you just stand here alone.
So glad that you decided to come here and play marbles together. Because we always play marbles together. It's our signature game. You know what I mean?
Yes. And you know what? I think that we should start a marble club.
Oh, a marble club!
We could share our love of marbles. They won't call us crazy anymore.
We can have a marble club, a marbles club. We can trade marbles and we can play marbles and we can do that today without marbles. That's what we can do.
Green ones and blue ones and all kinds of fun ones. We can be loved and popular.
Yes.
Let's do it together.
Purple ones and yellow ones and whatever we want. Even gray. We can have everything we want. We play the game that we love. Marbles.
And we're gonna spread and share it. Let's hang the signs!
Okay! Let's do it! Yes!
Well,
sweet. That was great. I could have swear, Johnny, I only had 2 marbles in my hand 10 minutes ago, and now there's 4. I don't understand what's going on here.
Oh my God, are they bleeding?
Isn't that weird?
Well, I can't think of what else it is.
I can't either. You know what? There's a little hatch on it. Look at that. They take batteries. Take a look.
Wow. Wow. I
don't think these are marbles. I think these are from like spies or something, Johnny.
Like, wow. And they multiply. I can't even imagine what that would be used for. Is that some sort of intelligence gathering technique?
I don't know. Maybe it's from like UFOs or something. I think we found something big.
Something big. I don't know. Should we take this to our parents?
No. Oh my gosh. We gotta keep it secret. You can keep it secret, can't you?
Well, I don't know. I've been trying to be honest. Trying to keep them in the loop. I don't know if I could keep a secret. Or I'm such a dupe.
No! Don't call yourself a dupe! You're really smart! I think you could take apart these marbles. Johnny, keep a secret.
Keep a secret.
We need to get to the bottom of this.
We need to find answers for us and the world.
Wait, they just went off! The marbles escaped! Oh my God!
After them!
They're after them! What's going on?
God, they're moving so fast and it's downhill.
There they go!
Are they laughing?
They're laughing!
Laughing marbles!
Laughing marbles!
Laughing marbles!
Laughing marbles!
Laughing marbles! I think the last laugh will be on them.
Never can catch us.
Oh my God! Oh, there's 4 more! Oh my gosh, they're gonna take over the world! Johnny, I'm scared!
Are you sure we can't tell our parents? I really think we need to tell them if they're taking
over. Okay. Tell us! We'll tell them, Johnny.
Sweep, cut to Johnny's parents' house. Johnny! Honey, where's Johnny?
That's a good question.
Right here, Father.
There he is. Oh, there you are.
Sit down, son. Your mother and I have a few questions for you.
Yes.
Go ahead, honey.
We were just wondering what all that ruckus was. It seemed like there was something going on. Something strange.
Yeah, and the Geiger counter in my workshop is going off. I don't know what's happening in your bedroom.
Well, I was outside playing with Janet, and she was pointing to these marbles in her hand, and he brought 2, but when she looked at her hand, there were 4, and then they started rolling downhill and laughing.
Johnny, what did we tell you about lying?
Right.
Tell
we're
us
not
the truth.
Lying. It's what happened.
What? Wait a
honey.
Minute. Are you? Is this one of your imaginary games that you had before? Because that doesn't sound right. It really doesn't.
Son,
the marbles
have you been
laughing?
Son, have you been smoking cigarettes?
Or even worse, candy cigarettes.
No, I've not been smoking either.
Son. Son, I have to tell you, you
what?
Cannot try any cigarettes, no candy cigarettes, No bubblegum cigarettes. No real cigarettes. No cigarellos. No cigars. No Black and Mild. You can't try any of it.
There's something. There's something wrong with our Johnny. And I think it may be his lungs. He must be smoking candy cigarettes or something that has sugar in it, my dear.
Okay, Johnny, why don't you tell us what you've been doing, whatever it is, even if it's not smoking anything, because, see, you look sad or you look upset or something and we don't know what's going on.
Tell us the truth and we'll still love you forever.
I'm sad because my own parents don't believe me. I'm unhappy because I tell them the truth and they throw it at me. Why can't you believe me about the marbles? I've only ever tried to convince you of what happened.
Oh, Johnny.
Come on, you just have to bring Janet in here. She can tell you.
Janet, where are you?
Maybe your friend will tell the truth.
Well, I don't know what Janet's going to say, but Janet, can you tell us what's going on here?
Spill the beans.
You can really use your help.
Please, Janet, confirm the truth.
There's a giant marble outside on your lawn. I've never seen anything like it. I think it's a bomb. There's two or three climbing in a bush. Oh my gosh. I think you better run.
Oh my God. I can't believe it. What did you just say? I can't understand it.
Honey. She said there's a giant marble on the lawn, and there is one. She wasn't lying.
I can't believe it.
Wow.
What should we do, kids? You're more familiar with these marbles than we are. Are they dangerous?
You know.
We just want to be loved. We just want a big hug. We just want to be understood. And we want more friends. That's why we reproduce.
Know what? We're the adults, so we should probably figure out what to do. I think these marbles aren't dangerous. And of course, neither are our kids, too. Ooh, what should we do?
What should we do?
Come on in. Roll yourself in our front door.
Wow, I haven't been invited in before.
Come in!
I'm sure they don't eat much.
Oh, well.
How about a hug?
Thank you.
No, careful.
It's a, what is, oh,
just what is
take
it, Johnny?
Out everybody. Take out everybody, but leave Michael. Johnny, you know what? I think there's something wrong if your parents didn't even believe you. You're the most honest guy there is. Who cares about these marbles? Your parents, they should have your back.
I know. I feel like the marbles believed in me more than my parents ever did. Maybe the marbles should be my new parents.
I think so. They seem kind of nice. Your parents, it was heart-wrenching how they didn't believe you. I wanted to stick up for you, but... Johnny, you know, I believe in you. I believe everything you say. I would never doubt you.
Thank you, Janet. I want you to know how much that means to me. You've always been there. From second grade through fifth. You've always been there.
Yeah.
In there through thick and thin.
Yeah. We've always been there for each other. Those marbles are kind of loud. They kind of look Sounds like they're having a party.
Yeah, a marble party.
I hope they're not evil and kill your parents or anything.
Yeah, I did. Doesn't do nothing.
Oh my God, Mom. Mom, why are you here?
I'm here just to check on your marbles. I'm not a marble, but I was just checking just to make sure nothing was going wrong.
You seem to care more about the marbles than you care about me.
Oh, of course not. I could never do that. You're so important to me. You're important to us.
We loved you, Johnny. We're racked with guilt now. We started smoking candy cigarettes because we've lost your love and we've lost your trust.
Oh, you could get his trust back maybe if you gave him some really cool marbles, you know, like Tiger Eye and the real metal ones. And you need to try to win his love
and
back.
And the amber ones that have things in them.
Yeah.
Your mother and I have been in carving one, and it just takes a while to sculpt it. Look what we've got so far.
Wow.
Couple marbles here for you, Johnny.
Oh my God! Thank you, Mom. Oh,
it's the big marble. The big marble. The big marble says you can help.
Oh.
Because we're family, and we're friends.
We're friends.
We're family and we're friends.
Marbles and humans alike.
Moms and dads and kids and friends and friends.
And kids and friends and friends.
We just want hugs.
We all want hugs.
We just want to play in the street.
You believe your son now, right, parents?
We would believe if our son told us he was traveling to the moon tomorrow.
It's actually the day after.
Yeah, what? I'm going too.
Congratulations, kids.
Yeah.
We made amends.
We made amends. We made amends.
We're all friends.
We're all friends and we all made a mess.
Scene.
Everybody give a hand to Team 4. Go ahead and turn on your video and give them some love. That was Team 4 with accompaniment from the band. And why am I using
Woo.
Head
phones? Woo band!
Woo! 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 Woo!
Hey, band!
Awesome!
Robertson?
Alrighty, so everybody go ahead and turn off your video. And this is the share your stuff part of the jam. If you happen to be working on anything, like you have an upcoming show or jam, or you just want to share some project you have going on, go ahead and pop on your video. And when I call on you, let us know what it's about. Mr. Donovan, of course.
Hey, how's it going, everybody? I'm going to put it in the chat. And the Facebook group, but Improvised Horror Movie is Friday, October 9th, 2020 at 8 p.m. Eastern. And if you want to play on a mashup team and do the movie format, which I explain, you can do that. It's Zoom to YouTube live stream. Send me a message if you'd like to play. All are welcome. Thank you.
Thank you, Donovan. Jess?
The Big Canvas Training Center is running a jam every Thursday at 7 p.m. Central, and it's for all levels of expertise with improvising. So if you're watching this on the stream and you've never done improv before, this is your chance to try it out. And if you've been doing it for a long time, it's also your chance to play with other people. And it's just Big Canvas Training Center on Facebook or the link that I shared in the internal chat.
Thank you, Jess. Okay, anybody else have a jam or show, or maybe you're teaching some improv classes or acting classes you want to talk about? Nick?
Yes, just wanted to shout out that every Wednesday at 9:30 Pacific, we have Open Court, hosted from Curious Comedy live in Portland, Oregon. So please check that out. You do need to, if you have not ever played at Open Court before, you do need to pre-register just to make sure that you're an actual human being and not some kind of robot, because we don't improvise with robots. So check us out, curiouscomedy.org. I'll throw it into the chat in a moment if I can. And just check us out in general, curiouscomedy.org.
Thank you, Nick. And oh, Scarlett, please.
Hi, I'm Scarlett. At Brooklyn Improv Training has Zoom improv jams every other Mondays at 7 p.m. to 9 p.m., a two-hour jam Eastern time. And this Tuesday, September 29th, we do a 30-minute set, and then we open it up to a jam hoof to whoever's in our Zoom audience. That is Zoom to YouTube live stream. That's 8 p.m. Eastern time. Thank you.
Thank you, Scarlett. And I'll be sharing the link in a moment. But besides sharing your links in the chat, I'll encourage you to share them to the hub page. Because as soon as this Zoom's over, those links are gone. Brian, go ahead.
There we go. So I think I mentioned in previous ones. I'm on the board of Otherworld Theater Company in Chicago, where we do improv with robots because it's a science fiction fantasy theater company. Next weekend we are having our giant gala. I can do that. It's a virtual gala online with hosted by Harvey Guillen from What We Do in the Shadows. We're also going to have Christian Nairn, Gates McFadden, Marina Sirtis, and a bunch of other celebrities joining us for part of that. Tickets are still there available, but if nothing else, we have an Eventbrite page. We go to otherworldtheater.org, and you can sign up for a free ticket for the main show, which will be at 7 o'clock next weekend, on next Saturday, Central Time. Find out what the theater's company is, and if nothing else, signing up for those free tickets helps us with grant organizations that look for a number of supporters and stuff. So, anyway, if you're interested, there's some really cool stuff coming up, digital and not, so hope people check it out.
Very cool. Thank you, Brian. So some of you, if you've especially been to the jam before, you may have heard that we actually created two house teams. We have both Bantam Roosters, who's headlining tonight, and Unicorn Kingdom, who headlined a few weeks ago. But both of them participated in the Palm Beach Improv Festival, which actually went on this week and is having its after party as we speak. So could all the performers from Bantam Roosters and Unicorn Kingdom come on screen and just wave to the crowd?
Yay.
It was a really great festival. It was run by Anthony. I'm sorry, I'm going to try not to butcher his last name. Anthony Francis Kutaya and Marissa Kutaya, located out of Palm Beach, of course. Lovely people. Really fun festival. Even though it was online, it was fantastic. They streamed to all the platforms, so it was really accessible. They took feedback and suggestions from all over the place. It was really cool. And I can only imagine what their days were like, because it was like 6 hours of content a day. Also, I'd like to give a shout out to the volunteers. So all the volunteers, go ahead and pop on screen and everybody give them a hand. And if you are interested in volunteering yourself, once again, I'll share the link. Go ahead and message the Inner City Longform Improv Jam page and we'll get back to you. And now, the moment you've been waiting for, we've got our headliner. Go ahead and turn on your screen as I call on you. We have Bantam Roosters. First of all, backed up by the band.
Woo!
Featuring Bianca Garcia, Don Robertson, Danelle Meager, Nick Condon, Josh Jenkins, Laura Zaro, Brian Sebi, Faustina Solis as our musical director, and playing with the band.
Woo!
And David Hepburn! Yeah. Hey. Woo!
Woo! And David Hepburn!
Yeah.
All right. Good evening, everybody. As you heard, we are the Bantam Roosters. And for those of you who don't know what a Bantam Rooster is, because I really didn't know, it's a rooster that is significantly smaller than average. So for our suggestion tonight, I'd like you to shout out something of yours that is significantly smaller than average.
Huh.
Patience.
My lawnmower.
I didn't quite hear the first one, but I heard lawnmower.
Memory.
So,
reading speed.
Shoe collection.
I'm going to go with lawnmower. That was the first one I heard clearly. So thank you for your suggestions, and we are going to do lawnmower.
You know, I'd love to invite you in for a nice tall glass of lemonade. You've been out there working in that yard so long.
It's what I do, sweetie. It's what I do. Thank you.
Look, you work so hard keeping this family together, keeping this yard pristine, keeping the kids off our lawn. You deserve more than a glass of lemonade.
Well, it's about time you recognize that I am underdeserved in this house.
Tell me,
everything that I do for you. I do for the kids.
I know. Tell me what you need, baby. Tell me what you need.
You want to know what I need?
I literally just asked you to tell me that. Yes. So.
Okay, I will tell you what I need. I need you to make sure that I am seen by you. I feel like I haven't been seen. Oh, dear. Everything that I've been doing, I check in with you first. Make sure the kids are taken care of. And I'm last with that list. Everything I'm doing, I be fair. Doing your own thing, quiet everywhere else but here.
What I'm hearing is that you need more. Let me tell you what I got in store. I'm gonna give you more. I'm gonna treat you right. I'm gonna treat you the way you wanna be treated tonight. And for every day moving on, I'll greet you with love from dusk till dawn.
I remember our wedding vows. This was the same thing you said. Now everything I do, oh, it just gets in my head. I don't feel appreciated, mentally, emotionally compensated. You're over there, I'm over here. Let's get together and be near.
Let's get together right now.
How is this going to be different than the last time?
I'm going to try, baby. I'm going to try.
These universal camouflage suits that you got us are working a bit too well. I'm very, very scared that I might shoot you.
I'm sorry, did you say cauliflower suits? Was that what I heard?
No, you're being on broccoli head. I said camouflage suits.
Oh, camouflage suits. That's right. That's right. They're the biggest thing this season.
But these are universal. They change wherever you go. Streets, office, no matter where you go, you blend right on in and disappear.
That's true, Jimmy, but check this out.
Whoa!
I got on neon camouflage.
Well, that's a fine. How do you do? That suits you so swell.
Well, thank you, Jimmy. I mean, I just thought I'd change things up a little bit. Like you said, camouflage.
Well, hold on.
It's something that's been around for a while.
Hold on a second. Let me show you this right here. You ready? You ready?
I'm ready. What you gonna show me?
Yeah. Kaleidoscope.
Woo. What? Kaleidoscope camouflage? You've got to be kidding me.
Custom designed by Donna Karen. Woo!
Oh, my word. Well, I think you just outdone me this season.
Well, that's the first time for everything there, ain't it, Rufus?
You have absolutely the best fashion sense. We have the best fashion sense.
Oh, we are a fashion duo. Me and you are.
Fashion connoisseur.
Oh.
I am sure.
Aficionado bravado.
We are fashion masters.
Fashionistas. But I like fashion masters.
Fashionistas.
Fashionistas.
You and me, we're striking all these things. We got camouflage and kaleidoscope, and oh my god, it's so dope.
So dope.
Fashionistas. Ooh. Who we are. Fashionistas. And that's who we are.
So strike a pose. Be a diva. Go ahead and be the queen of Sheba. If you need to, you can do it, cause you do whatever you need us.
Fashionistas, we're fashionistas, yeah.
Fashionistas,
fashionistas. You and me are fashionistas.
We're cover people, you. Girl, look at you. You better get it, go and work it. Get it, work it, get it. Now hold it, now squeeze, now goodness, now pose, now stand. Go ahead, that's right, you got it, your turn.
Fashionistas.
Fashionistas.
Say fashionistas. We look so good it hurts. Cause we're wearing really cool shirts. Fashionistas.
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 Everybody wants to be just like you and me.
Like fashionistas.
Fashionistas.
But they can't do it. Because you and I are the only two.
Yes, we are. We're fashionistas.
We're Front Page News.
Yeah, we are.
Sweet, sweet, sweet. I want to get some cooler clothes, Mom. I mean, everyone's just making fun of me on the playground.
Honey, we don't have money for that. How can we buy new clothes for you?
Even just one cool thing, just every day, I feel like I'm just a joke to everyone.
But your clothes are cool. Your dad, he was such in fashion, and you're wearing all his cool things that he used to wear when he was your age. You look so cool.
Mom, no one knows who Milli Vanilli is. No one, like, when I tell people that they're as cool as ice, I just get looks back at me.
Honey, you have to have more self-confidence.
Nice hammer pants, loser.
They don't like my hammer pants either. I mean, they're awesome, I admit it. I mean, this is cool, but I need some modern cool.
I fell in love with your father in those pants.
Oh. I don't know if I...
You should be proud to be wearing those. Your father was a great man.
You're wearing your dad's love pants. Ew.
Just to go out on a limb, does he maybe have stuff that's even older?
Actually, your dad has some really cool stuff from the 50s. 50s rock! Your dad has 50s rock! He goes and he rocked around the clock, and he wore his stuff 50s rock.
Maybe I can't be a retro cool kind of guy. I wear my hair all slicked up and tell everyone that I'm fly. I can't be like Elvis or Elton John. Although I guess he was a little late or so long, but I can just put it on and a beat. A 50s guy I'm gonna be. So dang fly, I'm gonna be.
You're gonna be so dang fly. You're gonna be that 50s guy. You're gonna blow everyone out of the sky.
And they can't stop me.
They can't stop you.
They can't touch me.
They can't touch you.
I'll blame it on the rain. I'll be a 50s guy.
A 50s guy. You're gonna be that nifty, nifty, 50s guy.
Gonna be so cool.
So cool.
No one will think I'm a fool.
Neato.
And though I don't have a brother, I say once again, word to you, mother.
You're welcome, son. I'm proud of you.
Let's retro it up.
Retro.
Smells so fresh out here, James.
Yeah, it smells like patchouli and honeysuckle.
I remember. It's been years since I got one of the little honeysuckles and just suckled the honey from them. Oh, man. They taste as good as I remember, James.
Yeah, that reminds me when I used to take pitch and get a little bit of that pitch, and then I'd be like, Julie, for Julie.
Mm. You called it Julie?
Yeah, that was kind of my power move.
Oh, man. I wasn't sure for a second. I thought you sneezed and I was just going to say bless you. That's how my sneezes sound. I mean, I get allergic sometimes. But Julie!
That's kind of...
Bless me.
Kind of adorable, actually.
Hey.
Did you work on that? You had to perfect that. Come on, tell me the truth.
It took some time. It took some time, but
I want what? Honeysuckle.
In Zoom time.
Why, thank you. Quite the gentleman. Blessing my fake sneeze.
Yes.
You don't find that very much these days because Divory is dead.
But it's not anymore with us.
Yes. Oh. Thank you, Winthorpe.
Well, you see, I have it in for you and me. We'll make different sneezes for all of our needs. You can sneeze right here, achoo, or sneeze real loud,
Ooh, bless you.
Well, thank you. All right on the spot.
How about this? I think we could even add a scent to the spritz.
Ooh.
When you sneeze along the cobblestone road, oh, the women in their bonnets, they would stop, and it would seem as though hard butter until it blows.
And then you can pull out your handkerchief to the ladies.
My lady.
And they will think that you are the dating tomorrow at the movies or the theater. You can go if you sneeze, if you please.
Oh, please. Oh, just sneeze. Oh, just sneeze.
Achoo.
Just please. Achoo. Oh, please. Oh, just achoo. Sneeze. Oh, sneeze. Achoo. Oh, sneeze. if you please, just sneeze. This is our favorite song.
I lost that one.
Oh, but you. Truly a gentleman.
A gentleman.
No man more gentle than we. No man more gentle than we.
No man
more gentle than we. We are shooting the truth, be.
Achoo! Achoo!
Honey. I found essential oils in her son's room.
What? Are you sure they were essential oils?
It says right on this vial, essential oils, patchouli, vetiver.
No.
Vetiver, for crap's sake. I don't even know what that is.
You've got to, that can't be real. Oh my God. I'm speechless.
Where did we go wrong? There's sage, clary sage. I didn't even know those were two different things.
Oh. We have to talk to him immediately. I mean, we can't just pretend like we don't know what's happening here. Our son, he's... Son.
Mom, Dad, I have something weird I want to ask you.
Of course, honey. What is it?
Have you been going through my stuff? And if so, have you taken any oils that are essential?
Bobby, your father might not want to say this, but I will. We are not going to let you become holistic.
No.
It's not right. It's not how we raised you. It's not how we were raised.
I know you guys weren't raised that way, but I know that we just, you guys got to change with the times.
Honey, that stuff is black magic.
And we will not have magic in our house.
Next, you're going to tell me I'm going to have to throw away my crystals and...
You have crystals?
Energy out of the house.
Honey. Oh my. This is worse than I thought. Where did you get these things? Was it your friends at school?
I met a lady, Mom.
A lady?
Yeah. I guess I can tell you a little bit about it then.
Well, tell us now.
She has so many things. She likes to read tarot cards, and she has 11 rings. One, I know it to be true. If you listen to me, I could show it to you. Please give me a chance tonight. I can bring you to dinner. Let's please not fight. Oh, Mom and Dad, won't you listen to me? The oils are essential, but they aren't free.
I don't know. I'm disappointed. This is a feeling that I've never felt. Honey, do you understand? We're from the Bible Belt. I'm overwhelmed. Somebody please tell me what's going on now. Somebody please help me now.
See what's going on. We got a heathen in the house.
Heathen in the house.
I'd like the sage right here then.
Back! Honey!
Yeah, Mom?
Put down the sage, honey, and step away slowly. Your father and I are just very, very concerned for your safety. Please.
Step away from the stage.
We promise we won't be in a rage. Slowly now, slowly now.
Slowly now. Good boy.
Sweep, 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 sweep. Yes, all of the kids have taken our free sage. It's only a gateway to crystals. And before long, they will be spending so much money.
They'll be spending all of their allowances and their Pokemon cards.
This was the greatest scam you've ever thought up. I mean... The war on smoking and that has cut into our previous plans too much, but this holistic medicine.
They'll never see it coming. The holistic medicine, the magic.
Indeed, and then the next step, we'll keep drawing them in. And oh, you need a tarot deck. Oh.
Oh,
that will be $50.
Oh, you need some D&D? You need some characters? Oh, you need some loot? Guess what? That'll be...
And then you can...
$40.
You can cast real magic.
Real magic.
Magic will be the increasingly size of our checking account.
Oh, we'll make hundreds of dollars. Hundreds?
Hundreds!
Hundreds upon hundreds. Yes! Hundreds upon hundreds. Just stacking up dollars. Hundreds upon hundreds. Ah, there'll be followers.
Stacking up those dollars.
Stack him up.
Stacking up De Niro.
De Niro.
Stacking up more types of money.
Stacking.
Ooh.
Like euros and Deutschmarks.
Those fatbacks. Those greenbacks. All of the money. We're gonna do it and we're gonna tickle ourselves like it was funny. We're gonna get all the wealth.
Money.
Yes. Monopolize it. So that we can just build ourselves.
There's no Satan here.
Money.
They're just dollar bills. But we never let them know.
Money.
That money is magic. And it's just so tragic. When no one else has it, then yes, we
are magic.
And for $40,
magic,
they can have a hat.
It's so magic.
It's all magic.
Magic.
Money.
It's good magic.
Magic.
We have it.
We'll make it disappear.
Ooh.
Our bank account here.
growing. Can you see the future?
I see the future.
I see the future.
I see us
in the Bahamas.
Ruling the world from the Bahamas, sipping pina coladas with all the Bahama Mamas.
Because of the magic.
The magic.
I of course mean money.
Money, 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 money. Oh, the money, just the magic and the money.
And maybe even gold pressed platinum.
Excuse me, Pixel.
Magic.
Stop.
Buy these on you.
Evening for me and probably for most of you, but we've been international players today, and I am feeling the magic. So, alrighty, that was the headliner. Now this is the part where everybody gets to play, should they want to. We're going to play a line game, which is going to be run by Mr. Brian Sebi. Come on in, Brian.
Hello. Let me see if I can find a more appropriate, like, supery background. this one will work. Yes. So this game is one I thought of called Legion of Superheroes, which I'm sure has probably been done before, but so we will be getting some items, and from those you will be inspired to come up with your own new superhero name, and then tell us your catchphrase or some line that you would use to fight crime. So if, say, their assistant was Banana, I could say, "Hello, I am Captain Banana, and no villain shall slip from my hands." It's pretty dumb. Just to start us off, just a suggestion of just some object.
Keys?
I heard keys. So keys is our suggestion. This is, in fact, the bean in Chicago. I figured... protecting a town. So, superheroes based on keys.
David. I am Super Keys, and I've got this town on lock.
Woo-hoo. David.
I am Key Man, accept no duplicates.
Kevin.
I am the Piano Man, and I will sing you a song.
Nice.
Michael.
I am the key man, and I will treat my foes like limes and make a pie out of them.
Danielle, you are mute.
My name is Francis Scott Keyman.
Shush! I am the true skeleton. Ooh. I messed it up again. Keys, I am Captain Keys. Skeletons gather round. Going out of state.
Josh, I'm going to put you in the burn box.
All right, let's do it.
Can we have maybe like a location that, you know, like, you know, there's always Captain America, Captain Britain. What's another location-based name?
Ireland?
Germany?
Ooh.
Jamaica.
I like Ireland. Just like an island-based superheroes.
All right. Let's see. Hello. I am Captain Ireland, and I just want you to take this sand in your face.
The band.
I am Island Man because it accurately describes my ethnicity.
Yes.
I am Captain Island, and I am no man.
Michael.
I'm Captain Island. Let's archipelago!
Hey! I am Captain Greenland, and I appear to be much bigger than I really am. Anyway, Nick.
I am Captain Island. Mess with me, and your life will be a beach.
Greg.
I am a rock. I am an island.
Laura.
I'm Captain Island. I'm coming in. Watch while I land.
Stephanie. Oh, you were there and then you disappeared.
That was my same one.
You know what? Danelle, you've been up there for a while, but I'm going to put you in the burn box as well. Oh. Can I maybe get a suggestion of maybe it wasn't like an object around your house?
Broom.
Vacuum.
Room. So we're captains, we're superheroes based on a broom.
I am Captain Broom, and I'm going to make a clean sweep of this entire island. Wilson, I'll be right there.
Nick.
I am Captain Broom. Prepare to be swept away.
Rusty Bill.
I am Captain Broom, and crime makes me bristle.
Dawn.
I am Broom Woman. Hooray for sexist stereotypes.
All right. Michael, I'm putting you in the burn box for fun. I don't know. Let's get me one more of what's something you just really love doing? Some activity.
Dance.
Improv.
Sorry?
Dance. Improv.
Ooh, dance. I like superheroes based on dance.
I am the dancer. I will sweep them off their feet.
The Faustino.
I am the dance captain, so everybody do this. Ooh, dance captain. Take a musical improv workshop with Laura Hall. Dance captain, right? Yeah, that's it.
Mind control man.
Let's see. Donna Paul, you're on screen. I'll make you do one.
Hi, this is Captain Salsa. And I've got the moves.
David looks very determined.
Captain Dance, it is I, your enemy. Foot blisters.
I'm sorry, there were two Davids. The other David may go.
I am Captain Pirouette, but I'm actually dry.
Laura.
I am Captain Dance. Don't twist my words around.
Michael Ostrowskis.
I'm Captain Dance. Let's tango.
Michael. Oh, let's end it there. Thank you, everyone. That one's just dumb enough to end on, so thank you, everyone. So please lead us out.
Thank you, Brian. Oh my gosh. Well, we are wrapping up. I'm just checking the spreadsheet. Oh, of course. Let's get a drum roll going. Because I'm going to announce next week's headliner.
Drums, 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 drums.
Faustino, I'm stealing your sound. So the headliner for next week.
Sensitive topics.
Oh, I jumped back a bit so you couldn't see it before I hit preview. I am. Headliner next week is Impromptu Improvised Plays from Sarasota, Florida. They do improvised unscripted plays set in the post-World War II era. That is 40s and 50s. Give that a hand.
Woo! Yeah.
Woo! Oh my gosh, let me get my spreadsheet back. So everybody, go ahead and turn on your video and let's get a group picture. So if you really don't want to be in it, you don't have to turn on your video. But it's lovely to see everybody that's here, stuck around to the end. Okay, just waiting on a few more. Kevin and Stephanie, if you're still around, although I know Kevin might be busy, busy, busy. All right, everybody, smile beautifully for the camera. Cool. And now we're about to go offline. So wave to all your friends and family that watched.
Bye, everyone.
And bye.
Bye-bye, Facebook.
We're famous.
Bye.
Let me grab one of those.
I know all these people.